So up here, those of you that are pretty sure you've thought of most everything you can think of, you've used your crayfish structures or the diagram to use as kind of a checklist. You can go down and make sure you've included them, gotten enough ideas. I want you to turn, not yet, just listen to the directions. So you're going to turn this notebook page over. Your Venn diagram will get turned over. You don't have to do that yet. This is a hard task that I'm going to ask you. It's going to take a lot of thinking, so I need your full attention. I'm going to ask you to write at least 3 sentences. So my expectation is that you have at least 3 sentences. You could get a 5 if you had more than 3, okay? So I want you to write 3 sentences explaining how the crayfish and snails are similar and different. Remember, similar is close to same, and you know different. They're not, right, they're not alike. Here's an example of a sentence you could write. Crayfish and snails are similar because they both have shells that protect them from predators. I would expect 3, thank you for asking, 3 from your own brain. You could write a sentence about how those shells are different, though. Okay. Let me give you an example of a sentence for different. Okay. Crayfish and snails are different because crayfish have walking legs to help them move, but snails have 1 foot. So that's how they would be. That's how they would be different. Okay? 3 sentences. If you finish early on another part of your paper, this is if you finish early. Just write a few questions to explain what more you would like to know. What are you still wondering about? For example, Calvin had mentioned a question in our science talk. Okay? So these are for the early finishers. Okay?
I use that one.
Okay, and if you had time, you could go back and look and see some of the other ones, okay?
They're both the same because they're
but you've got some really key ones. So why don't, so you want to think first, or do you want to talk out a sentence about how they're similar or different?
The snail is different because one's slimy and one's kind of not.
So. And can you, so I do want you to explain how it, why are they slimy?
Because.
So the word because is important. Good job. Can you tell me how their shells are different?
Snails go under the shell.
Mm-hmm.
And crayfish just make the shell harder.
Nice. So you used that thought, but you're thinking even a little bit deeper about how they're using the shell. So write that exactly. Nice. Okay. How's it going over here?
I just need one more sentence.
So thank you for explaining what the function is. So will you do me a favor? Because this could actually extend it, okay? Crayfish and snails have something to move, which is correct. That's the similar, right? Or were you going to do, are all these similar?
Yeah.
Okay, and then are you going to do a few about differences?
Yeah.
Okay. Then you would probably talk about the differences. Like they both have... One has walking legs, though. Got it. So you have a plan. So let's get one more sentence, because we have 2 now, okay? So wait, hold on. They both have their shells, right, to help them for protection. when a predator comes, with snails, and then crayfish shells can be hard or soft. And what about the snail shells? So maybe add that part on there. All right. Your notebooks, you know where they go? Your Venn diagram needs to be handed to your team captain for Evie to pick up. What do you think? And like I said, if you needed some more time, like you were working on some questions and you want to make sure to
get those on your paper, you can have a little bit more time later. So let's go back to our focus question. How do the structures of a crayfish and snail compare or contrast?
They kind of have the same shell, but one's harder than the other.
So, let me just get a sentence started here. So we could say some structures are similar. So let's just share some ideas about similarities.
Eyes. Malia?
Shell.
Angelo? Brittany, I heard you sharing one. Eyes, shell.
Mouth
and head. Pretty good, huh? Some structures are similar, like... let's put a mouth, or we could say, mouth, bless you, eyes, head, and shell, right? Other structures are very different. Like Leo, what was one structure that was very different?
The
legs. Walking legs and a foot, right? Marisol? Sam? Yeah, the antenna and the tentacles. Right? Brianna? Right. We learned that word for two animals, but very different, right? The crayfish have an egg pore. And the snails have a respiratory pore or a breathing hole, huh? So, like tentacles. Walking legs and an. Since egg starts with E, we put an, right? And an egg pour. Okay. So I just want to, and my hope for you is that when, for the rest of your life, you are observing organisms, that you think a little bit more deeply about and question what structures does that organism have and what functions do those structures have, or what function does that structure have? How does that help them survive? And maybe even think a little bit about behaviors. We studied behavior a lot of the crayfish, right? I have a final question for you, though. I'd like to know what's been really interesting or surprising about snails that you've learned.
Surprising?
Yeah, interesting or surprising? I moved, Tim, hurry. You'll need to get a new partner. Brandon, can you talk, please? Hurry. Both numbers. Why don't you start it off? Keep going. You can finish your thought and then turn back. It's okay. Alani, what did you find that was really interesting or surprising?
That you could tell by the coral shell if it's right-handed or left-handed.
Yeah, I learned that in the science talk today.
Me too.
They don't even have hands.
Yeah.
Like,
and you know what? All of our observations, I hadn't even noticed that the coil might have been on one side or the other. And now that's going to make me even look even closer at our crayfish, you know, or our silkworms. Thank you. Jasmine? Thank you. I saw several heads turn back to Jasmine. Thank you.
I thought it was interesting when you push down the eye, when it comes back up, you can see the eye spot kind of going back up to
it. It's like black. You can see it.
Yeah. I know. It's like a big black line, but then at the...
I was just letting Calvin finish having his conversation with Lauren. Abby, what did you find really interesting or surprising?
I never knew that it had a glow hole at all.
Glow hole?
Yeah.
Like
sorry about that. Similar, huh? Yeah, I didn't know that either. I thought that was really, really interesting.
Why don't they have it on the
shell? I don't even think I had wondered how they breathed.
Why don't they even do it on the shell?
Ulysses?
But the heart is attached on the outside of the body. What?
Where is it?
When I picked it up, I saw the heart on the outside.
What did it look like?
It was red.
Or it was just red.
It was so hard to
He's asking you a question. Well, and we could definitely do a little bit more investigating to see if we can find out what, if Ulysses can kind of show us what he had observed. Yeah, absolutely. Okay. I'm curious. I'd like to do a little bit more investigating with that. Absolutely. Thank you. Okay. And I did hear several people talking about, I think it was Alexia and Alina, how that you were mentioning how the snail eats, right?
Oh, yeah.
And then it has that, yeah, that radula, that, mm-hmm, that tongue that's helping them eat. Now, one more thing I actually learned, I thought was really interesting. Oh, wait. I have most everyone's eyes. Thank you. One thing I thought was really interesting, and then it reminded me when I heard Alexia sharing with Alina, was Jeff hates snails. He wants them out of our garden. He wants to try to kill them all the time. And Alina shared with me yesterday about
Margaret Jean. She like puts salt on them and like lets them like get all bubbly.
They shrivel up.
Yeah. And Lauren had just said something, because they eat your garden. So a lot of people think of snails as pests. And we listen. I didn't realize, and I thought about it a little bit more, but I didn't realize that how snails are very, very, very useful and important to our environment and to our gardens.
They also eat
leaves. That, yes, they'll eat some of our, you know, the fresher leaves, but a lot of you know, like Natalie had mentioned, that you needed to open up the plants and you found them at the bottom, more where the dried or dead leaves were. They're a decomposer, so they help break down the dead leaves. Then they actually make our soil healthier, because through their scat or poop, they are replacing, they're putting all the vitamins and nutrients back in the soil, which actually helps our garden grow. So I did explain it to him. He's being a lot more tolerant or accepting of the snails. But that was a big aha moment for me. I've always thought of them as kind of a pest. But just something to think about is that how humans, we just think of, oh, they're eating our garden. But how important this organism, but all organisms are, they have a place in our environment. And we need to think about that before we just go and destroy them. Right?
We should think about what we should do before we do it.
We should. And we should do a little investigating before we make that decision, huh? So maybe what you can do, like Alina,
yes,
is maybe you can go and at least educate your families on the usefulness of snails and why we really do need them. Okay? Maybe it could be relocated. Okay? All right. When I give the signal word, can you have about 25 minutes to finish publishing. Okay? Ready? Cylindrates. Sac, body, one mouth.